Hello, I'm here. Sorry for letting you wait. Who is this? I don't know you. What happened to your beard? Aha, okay. And it's like the finish of a travel is remove the beard. Ah, okay. Yeah, I see. Yeah, I also cut, but only Roman's beard, but not like shaving it, but cut it in shape. Yeah, yeah. Okay. And are you still in jet lag? Yeah. Okay, cool. And what time is it now? La Plata? Okay, so midday. Yeah, so here it's already dark. So it's 8 a.m. and it's dark. So you left exactly at the right moment before the eternal darkness comes in. Before you get up in the morning and it's dark, and then you come home after work and it's dark, and it's always dark. And in between, it's cloudy and raining and everything is super depressive. So it's good that you are home. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I will be jealous, I guess. Yeah, we had a little rain. Yeah. Barbecue. Tasty. Yeah, so we started making stews, which is the thing in the winter time, eating a lot of stews and soups and stuff from vegetables in the garden. Now, and we harvested the wine and make juice out of it. The wine in the winter garden. Yeah. So I had the seedlings. So I had several questions. So today I peeked in the document you have sent me, and then I looked at this at the sheet, which is called Petri dishes, which contains the data for the germination trial, right? And then I calculated the number of the percentage of not of germination but of seedlings you have for each of them, and to estimate how much I will get. I don't think that the germination has its peak at 21 days, right? So they continue to germinate step by step. So this was my experience with the seeds Erika has given to me. Yeah. Do you have experience with the germination? I mean, how long it is? Yeah, but this is just the standard of Isabel, I guess. Yeah, yeah. So. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Oh, really? Okay. Ah. No, it's also, it would have been nice because I'm on the way anyway. So it takes 5 hours to go to Halle, and I'm on the way on Thursday is the way. So we will go to Roman's parents, and there we cross by Halle. And on Thursday we will go there, and on Sunday we will come back, but it's not a problem to also go later. And I was wondering, so at the beginning you sent me like germination percentages. With the and the graphs are also included in the Excel sheet, and I wondered, so they were partially very high, like 46%, but I couldn't find any dishes or where germination percentages were that high. So based on which data you have calculated? Wait, I can give you a host right, and then you, now you should be able to share your screen. Yeah, I see it. Wait, I see a black screen. Yeah. It's just a black screen, and like your chat name has started screen sharing. So maybe should I try? I also have the document. Now something happens. Yeah, but it's only black. I see a pen, but just like a black. Why doesn't it work? Wait, maybe I can share. Do you see the document? Yeah. So I download. So this is the. Yeah, so this is the petri dishes, and this is the number of seeds that have germinated, and this is the number of cotyledons. And like, is it possible to? Yeah, they germinated. And then is it possible, so these two are still the same ones as these two? They are still the same ones. So, okay, and then The first, okay. Okay. Emerge and one is left. And So then the calculations I did were two, because I just took the sum of this and the sum of this and the sum of this, and then I have to total the number of seeds that have emerged with cotyledons. Okay. So it's 33 in this case. And then I like calculated the entire number of seeds and like a percentage of emergence, just to know how much I will likely get. Okay. And then I saw you've sent me, where was it? I think here. So this is like with the, this is comparable to the, but this is like the germination, right? Okay. And therefore it's, I see. And and then you had these data, and I wondered, it's like 41% up. Okay, so the average germination is around 6%, basically. Okay. Then we will see. So we will likely keep our seeds for a longer time in order to make sure that we, so the germination, we will do it longer. Yeah. So this is something different, but just for the seeds I have here in Kiel, I would keep them for a longer time in the petri dishes and monitor them for longer, because I can remember that I had several, with the seeds Erika gave me, I had several peaks of germination. And I think it lasted 2 months until we decided to stop it, because nothing, it germinated. I know. So no, just for the seeds we will have in Kiel. And not for your seats. Yeah. 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 I saw the overview you have prepared, and then so I wondered, because I don't know the conditions in Halle now, because everything has changed. So there are two different options. Either it's like you said, so Victoria will collect them in a petri dish, and I will pick them up. Yeah, I don't differentiate. Yeah, so I don't differentiate between the seed weight data on. And then the second option. Okay. Okay, and the other option would be, and I wanted to ask, if this is also an option, we have prepared like this, these three nursery pots. So it's a palette consisting out of pots and with the soil. And theoretically, I can send it to Halle to put them already in, but I don't know. So currently you are working with germination cabinets and they are in the Biozentrum or? And in the Biozentrum, are there also, is there also greenhouse space? No, okay, and this is the problem. Okay, okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, she's at the Fowler Ort. So I will just try to go there whenever it's convenient for Victoria to pick them up. And I just wanted to know, so in case you have a clean greenhouse close, it would have been easy to just put them there. But in the other case, I will pick them up. Or maybe I can also find an option how to send them. There are some express package options. Okay. Good. I just wanted to check out all the different options we have. Yeah, I saw the photographs. So then likely I will include also, so Victoria would just give me everything you don't need. And not only for the plots where I have the seeds, but for all plots you have sampled, basically. Yeah, I only have certain plots, exactly, in most of them. But it's good to have maybe then the design changes a bit. But I would say, so I calculated that. So it's also better for me, actually. It is also better for me, actually, but I didn't dare to ask. I didn't dare to ask whether you can just give me everything that I, therefore I just asked for the plots I have. So it would be nice to in the end have some. And then it's even better. So I only did it like a selection of plots because I knew that I couldn't have anything and not too much, like that you wanted to do the experiment, but it's cool to have the remaining seedlings. So if you don't need them. So if you don't need them, just throw them into the dishes. Put everything into the dishes. I take everything. I'm not picky. Okay, I'm not picky. Yeah, and did you do the germination on filter paper or on glass beads? Filter paper. Yeah. Yeah, okay, this is the classical Halle approach. So I tried it with glass beads. So you have these very fine, maybe I can show it. I have, now what I mean, wait, I'll show you. I need to go to the cloud. Because we typically also do it like we do it in Halle with the little ring, and then you place a filter paper on top. But we realize that this causes a lot of mold, actually. And so we have it here in the cloud folder. Theoretically, you can also, do you see the photo? So, and then these are very small glass beads. They are super tiny. And then we have water, and the water is not like on the top of the glass beads, but approximately on the half. So, and these are Australis seeds. So we have two germination cabinets running, with one with the Tarapacana seeds and one with the Australis seeds. So, and we hope that we will not have that much mold. Yeah, so these are our germination cabinets, and Sarai and Tessa preparing everything. So first we wanted to do it on sand, but then we decided to do it with this. And we will also acquire, like you did it, we will monitor twice per week, because we want to prick the seedlings as soon as possible. And don't leave them too long in the dishes. And for each date, we will monitor whether the root emerged or whether the cotyledons emerge. So, and we do it like we have a little corner of the dish which is empty, and when a root emerged, we put the seed into this corner to assure that we don't count it twice. So but I will send an explanation of the data set then later on, and then I will send you the data, and do you want to use it and publish them along with your experiment? So I can also communicate with Vic about when to come. Wait, she asked. Okay, I need to give them back to Halle. Are the petri dishes, do they belong to another working group, or do they belong to Isabel? Because like petri dishes, they are super cheap glass petri dishes. So we can bring some. We have loads of them, and I can bring some. But typically, this is nothing you are like jealous for, and which you don't easily agree. Yeah, I mean it's a good point. It's a good point to just exchange them, or maybe send them back later. Would it theoretically also possible or convenient? I mean, Vic is there until the end of October, right? The 7th, I know that. And you said that the seeds, they can last very long in the petri dishes once they have. Would it be possible for me also to come later? Maybe I wait for another appointment and another, so like not the last time Victoria checks, but... Yeah, with thick. Ah. Okay. So I must not go there next week, but I can theoretically also come the week after that. Yeah, yeah. So I would definitely go there as long as Victoria is there, but she's, so next week is, let's have a look. So I return to Kiel on Sunday, and then we go on a writing retreat, which means our entire group goes on, we go to a hotel and we are writing papers for 4 days nonstop. So, and therefore I cannot afford to come this week. So either I have to come at the 30, which is inconvenient for Vic, or I come later, which could be like the 5th or the 6th, I don't know. But I can ask Vic when she has time. Right? Hmm. No. Hmm. Hmm. Okay, so it's theoretically, how deep is Isabel into the experiment? Not that much. Yeah, okay, I know. Yeah, because you said I could theoretically also ask Isabel, but I know that Isabel typically doesn't know what is going on exactly in the lab, and therefore I ask back if so. So the best address to ask is either Vic or Katrin, right? Hmm. 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 So I mean, everything you don't need for your germination trial, I would take it and I would try to grow everything up. And so we are prepared for that. So that this is what I actually need. I need the plans for the experiment. Yeah, yeah, okay, good. I have to sleep, why? Do I look tired? No, I'm not. It's like, it's the wrong light. It's because the light is coming from above there. Yeah, okay. Then I will write, maybe I can, if we communicate, I just send Vic and Isabel in CC for the emails. We communicate in order to avoid that everybody is communicating different things, right? Yeah, and so maybe to, yeah, I will ask Vic when we can meet and also talk to Isabel. And I just wanted to know how everything, because I wasn't sure how everything is arranged with the Biozentrum and the Botanical Garden. And therefore, I wanted to just make sure that we find the best way of exchanging the seedlings. And I mean, if if Isabel, if the botanical garden in Halle wants to have some polylepis trees, I could give them, so the Terrapacana trees, I could give them the ones I have raised from Erika seeds. So I still have 10. And I would like to have all the things that I have from your experiment. And if I have finished the experiment, I can give it back to Halle. But it would be nice to have all, not all, I mean, it's obviously, it's your work, but if you don't need it, I take everything with it. Yeah, that's actually it. Okay. Ah, okay, because the ones I have grown here, they have grown a lot and they look so different. I think they already have different growth forms. Is that possible already? Because some of them, they grow very bushy with like 5 or 7 little sprouts. And some of them have only one main sprout. And some of them are dark green and some of them are like silverish with a lot of hairs. So I have the entire morphological variety of Polylepis terrapacana, and I can give it to the botanical garden in Halle. You can tell this to you. So I have 10 individuals that are more older than 6 months. They are like 5 centimeters high now, and I can give these individuals to the botanical garden, and then they can have these individuals. Yeah, okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. And hello, Frieda. Hey, Frieda, come here, come on. Say hi to Manu. Hi, Manu. Yeah, Frieda was on a walk. She still has her GPS tracker on. Yeah. And did you already plan with Isabel that you come back? It sounded like you will come back in your emails. Did you plan any follow-up projects with her? Ah, okay. Yeah. Ah, okay. You can, yeah, visit and say. I mean, Roman and I are also still planning to go to Argentina. And will you also work with Christoph together? Did he join the Polylepis group or not? Yeah. Ah, okay. But then he wants to work with Bonitza and not with Polylepis. Yeah, I mean Christoph wants to work with Bonitza and not with Polylepis. Ah, okay. Okay. So maybe I will also try to, if there's this Polylepis conference, I will try to attend, and then I let you know what happened to the, because I had this DFG proposal with Polylepis australis, and I mean, you always get more than you apply for, and maybe if this is funded, I mean, you can come, and for, yeah, so, but yeah, I don't know if it's funded. So we will see. Okay, then everybody is staying in touch. And we are writing a lot of emails with Isabel in CC and so on. And so as soon as we have our data ready, you can look at the data in the cloud folder I've shared with you, but as soon as we are ready, I will send you the Excel sheets with all of the comments and stuff. Okay. And then, yeah, enjoy your it's not evening now, but the rest of the day. Rest of the day. Yeah, thanks for taking the time. And I know I'm asking a lot of questions about seeds and seedlings and stuff. Must be annoying, but yeah. So everything is settled now. Yeah. Okay. Then, yeah. See you soon, hopefully. Bye.